by faith we see the hand of God. In the line of creation's grand design. In the lives of those who prove his faithfulness. Who walk by faith and not by sight.
Good morning and welcome to the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. I'm sitting on my back deck as we get started with the Word of God today. You know how we do it. I'm Clint Davis, your host. We read the Bible and we talk about it. Luke chapter 6, verse 37 through verse 42. Here's the Word of God for us, Luke's version of the Sermon on the Mount. Judge not and you will not be judged. Condemn not and you will not be condemned. Forgive and you will be forgiven. Give and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put in your lap. For with the measure you use, it will be measured back to you. He also told them a parable. Can a blind man lead a blind man? Will they not both fall into a pit? A disciple is not above his teacher, but everyone, when he is fully trained, will be like his teacher. Why do you see the speck that is in your brother's eye, but do not notice the log that is in your own eye? How can you say to your brother, "Brother, let me take that speck out of that is in your eye," when you yourself do not see the log that is in your own eye, you hypocrite? First take the log out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to take out the speck that is in your brother's eye. These words are some of Jesus' most often quoted words. They're often the words that are most often quoted out of context and inappropriately and wrong. The idea of judging someone in the first section of this passage, verse 37 that we read a moment ago, the idea of judging and condemning is this idea of placing eternal consequence on someone's actions. A refusal to forgive, a refusal to acknowledge that person is worthy of redemption in the Lord Jesus Christ is cutting that person off. And he says, judge not lest you be judged. The last thing we want to do is cut ourselves off from the grace and mercy of God. And so therefore, we should not cut others off from the grace and mercy of God. We should not condemn them unnecessarily unto eternal damnation. Rather, we are to present the gospel to them and encourage them to come to know the Lord Jesus and find forgiveness of their sins. The way we do that is by offering forgiveness. Forgive and it will be forgiven. If we withhold forgiveness from other people, then we will not be forgiven by God. That's what Jesus says there. I think it's interesting. He also says that give and it will be given to you. Good measure will be laid in your lap if you treat people with good measure. And I love that concept, the idea of being kind, being gracious, being loving to other people, then they'll treat us that way in return. That's something that I learned as a child in my parents' home, and I've continued to try to apply that in my own life. It's something I'm trying to teach my children. The idea of the golden rule, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Treat people with goodness, treat people with respect, treat people with love, treat people with kindness, and for the most part, you'll receive that back. They may not always give it back to you the way you anticipate it. They may never give it back to you, but that's on them. That's not on you. What's on you is you do it, and the result of doing it oftentimes is that you'll be blessed beyond measure in it. Also, he continues on, and he talks about a blind man leading a blind man. A disciple is not above his teacher. Everyone, when he is fully trained, will be like his teacher. The idea here, he's talking to his own disciples, to those who are following him. And Jesus says, you're not going to be above me, but the goal in your life is to be like me, to reflect my life in your life. That's true for you and me as much as it was for the disciples to whom Jesus originally told this. You and I, our call is to be like Jesus. And so we're to be forgiving and gracious and treat people with good measure. Recognizing that God is God. But here's the thing, that the reason I said these verses are often taken out of context, because just after he says you'll be like your teacher, he says these words: why do you see the speck that is in your brother's eye and do not notice the log that is in your own eye? How can you say to your brother, "Brother, let me take the speck out of your own eye," when you yourself do not see the log that is in your own eye? You hypocrite. First take the log out of your own eye. And oftentimes that's the word. Don't judge. You got a big old log in your eye, and you're trying to find the specks in other people's eyes. And oftentimes that's used as a way that people can stop you from challenging, or stop me from challenging, or maybe I've used it in a way to stop other people from challenging me. in my sin. Jesus never says we don't challenge sin in people's lives. In fact, he says, you're not going to be greater than your master. You're going to be like your master. Jesus walks around and challenges sin in people's lives. Jesus didn't have a big old log in his eye because he's taken care, obviously, to live righteously. You and I, by nature, have logs in our eye because we're sinners. But we confess that sin. We bring it to the throne of God. We give it to the Lord Jesus himself. We trust him with our lives. And so we deal with it properly through faith and repentance. And as we deal with our sin, we go and challenge each other when we see sin there. We're slow to do that, but we're not afraid to do that. And we do that in a way to encourage them to come to know the Lord Jesus more fully and to live with him and to deal with the sin in their lives. It's done out of love. Jesus never says we don't question or challenge each other in their sin. He says we make sure we deal with our own sin first. And once we've done that, and as we're doing that, we encourage one another to walk with the Lord as well. So let me leave that with you today. You guys be good. Thank you for taking time to listen. Trust the Lord. Confess your sin. And be bold enough to encourage one another. Treat each other with kindness, but be bold enough to encourage one another to walk in righteousness. Have a great day. God bless you. We'll see you soon.